If you're using the DOM theme, then you know that the button customization is, well, boring, right? So let's liven it up with some custom CSS. Now, you can also use these codes for other themes, but I know that they will work for any free theme that is available inside the Shopify theme store. These will be the button customizations that you can create, and you can apply these to your whole website, or you can apply it to just one button. So let's get started. So we are in our dashboard, and I'm going to use the DOM theme version 12. So that's the one we're going to use today to show you how to customize buttons here. We're going to use this section here, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the image with text, right? Because I want to select this section here, and we're going to work on the custom CSS. Okay. The advantage of using the custom CSS is that you are able to create code here, which will only affect this section only. It won't apply anywhere else on your website. Okay. So what we'll do here, we'll start off in the custom CSS, because as we make changes, we can see them right away. Okay. And then we'll apply some to the site as a whole, but let's start with some custom CSS and let's have some fun here creating different button styles. Okay. So we're going to use this button here as an example. So we're going to go very simple, and we're going to use the code for the button text color. So as you see here, if I remove this, you'll see that the text is white, right? And I've added back, you see immediately that it changes black. Okay. So that is why I really like to use CSS here, because I can see it instantly. So the dot button, and then you add whatever code you want to add here. And you could add individual codes. You can build on this. You can create a lot of different things. Okay. So we've turned this button black, right? So you can turn this into whatever color you want. If we, let's go ahead and put it back to white. There we go. See how instant it is. And then the exclamation point, important. You don't have to always add this. I'm going to add it today for all of my examples, just so that you have it. Because there are some themes where the code, you have to include the important. Otherwise, it's going to grab the custom CSS that's already attached to the rest of the website. So as you can see, my buttons are set to have a white text. So if you're ever working on a code and it's not working, add exclamation point important and it should work for you. Okay. All right. So that's the first code that we want to add. Now, let's say we want to add the background color, right? So I want to change the background color. So you saw that how instant that was. So I want the background color to be black. So there it goes. So the background color became black. If I want this to be white, whatever color you need that background to be, that is the color that you're going to add here. So let's flip that. Let's make that white with the letters in black. All right. Now let's suppose you want to add a drop shadow to this button. So the drop shadow code for this would be this right here. I have it set to black. So as you can see here, the box shadow is black. And so you have several different numbers here. So this one obviously is your hex color. So you make that box shadow whatever color you want. We have it set to black so we can see it better. And then you have three different numbers here. And each of those numbers represent how you want that shadow to look, right? So let's make that from 2 to 20, and you'll see instantly what it does, right? So it moves it to the right. You go to the same thing on this one, and you make that a 30, right? So that second one is good to go to the bottom. The third one is the shadow effect of that box shadow. So how the glow, right? If you're used to Canva, what's that glow, right? How far that glow goes. So go ahead and put that back to 4. And then this fourth one, let's make that into a 50 so we can see what that does. And that also creates the glow. So instead of a glow, it's actually an outline. We want that to 0. We want a little bit of a glow. And you can change these around however you'd like. So how about you don't want a glow, and maybe you want, so you will put that one at 0 and you want an outline instead. So you change that 0 to 5, and then you have an outline. And then what you'll do, let's say you want an outline that goes perfectly centered. So then you make these, all of these other numbers 0, and then you'll see that your outline is centered. All right, so that is how you can add either an outline or you can turn that into a glow. I like the box shadow, the original code, so I'm going to go ahead and just put that right back. All right, so let's go ahead and save those changes. So again, these are all individual codes. Let's say you want the button to be exactly how it was when we first went to the site. You can just delete these and just use the box shadow if you just want to add box shadow. Okay, so you can use what you want, leave the rest. Okay, so we'll go ahead and leave that there. And if I come to the live site, you'll see that the effect only takes place in this image with text section here, right? It doesn't affect any other image with text that I have. Okay, so that's what's really awesome about the custom CSS here. All right, so let's continue and have a little bit more fun with these buttons, okay? The next one I want to show you how to do is a button hover. We want that button to change whenever we hover over it. And as you can see, I already added that code, right? So now it hovers over, right? It doesn't do it now, but once I save it. Okay, so here, whenever you're working with code and you see that message, that means there's something wrong with the code. And what it is right here. So I have the semicolon incorrect there. So let me remove that. All right, beautiful. And then save that. All right, that did the trick. And now we'll come over to the front. Let's refresh, and now you'll see that I'm able to hover over my buttons. Okay, so that is your button hover code. And again, I'll have everything in the description down below. All right, so you can change this background to the hover color, whatever you want. So this is going to be this background color here will be only to the hover button. So what do you want the background of the button to be when you hover over it? So I have it set to black, and then this is the white, which is the text, because you can also change that. So let's say I want the hover background to be black and the text to be red. So this is what I'm telling it. So now when I hover over it, there you go. All right, these are really fun. So that's how you add a hover button. So it's so much fun, isn't it? All right, so here is, let's say we want a, let's go ahead and remove this. All right. Actually, let's say we want to remove all of that. We don't want that. Let's say we want maybe, a box shadow when I hover over it. There we go. You see that slight box shadow there? Okay. And so these numbers are completely customizable. Let me show you a website where if you want to add the RGB numbers. So if you come over here, this pretty cool website is called RGB Color Picker. You can change your hex color to an RGB and vice versa, right? But you can change this however color you want it to appear. So let's go with a yellow here, right? So if you put the picker wherever you want that color to be, or if you already have your hex color, you can enter your hex color and it'll give you an RGB for it. What you'll do with this RGB is that you go ahead and copy it here, and then you come back and you can replace the RGB. All right, and now we hover over it, we'll see that is now the yellow. See that? Pretty cool. So feel free to play around with this. You're not going to break anything, okay? So just play around with it. So I want to introduce you to another resource that I use all the time. And if you want to create further customizations, then let me introduce you to W3 Schools. So this is a CSS school, and it teaches you how to create CSS for anything that you'd like. So you see all of these options that you have here. So since we're working on buttons, I come to this page here, and it shows you right here, tells you what it is. It gives you an example, and it gives you code for that button. And then you can try it yourself. So you can click on here, and then you can make whatever changes you want here. Click on run, and you can see exactly what it's going to do, right? So this is really, really cool. And yeah, so I hope that you use it. But here we go, button size, right? So it shows you, you want this button to be this size maybe. Okay, so then you can go ahead and try it yourself and play around with those button size, okay? The only trick to this would be that, see how it says button here? Depending on where you're using this CSS, you could use it in custom CSS just like this. So I could just come in here and just grab this and plug it right here and look. Did you see all of the changes, right? And then you can come in here and make whatever modifications you want. So let's say the margin, I want the margin to be 5, right? So the margin is the spacing between two elements. right? The spacing between inside of the specific element. So the spacing between the learn more and the border, that is actually your padding. So if I come over here and I turn that to 25, you'll see it'll go 25 top and bottom, and then 32 is from left to right. Okay. So that's what that does. And as you can see, the moment that you make a change, you can see it right here. So this is a really, really great resource for you to practice to do custom CSS for your own site. So sometimes, as you can see, you don't need the whole thing. It really depends on where you're using the CSS. Okay. So if you're wanting just to target a specific section, then you could just use this area here. But sometimes, like I said, sometimes it might not work. So sometimes it's button here, but maybe depending on your theme, you might need, maybe it might be something else. Maybe it might be the primary that you have to select. So the button primary, right? So it really depends, but you can always come in here. You're not going to break anything. So just try it. Okay. So let me go back and let me leave this box shadow here, right? So it's not going to have the hover. So we're just adding the box shadow. Okay. So I'm going to go back and use this code here. And so what this code here is saying, I want my background to be green with my text color to be white. And when I hover, I want the button to be black and my text to be white. So let's do that. Let's hover over it. There we go. Okay. So you can get your button to however you want your buttons to look right here. And then we'll go ahead and save that. Beautiful. So this is what I want all of my website buttons to be. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this. All right, and we're going to head over to our edit code, our code editor, because we're going to add this code so it affects the entire website. So what you'll do is click on those three ellipses there. You're going to click on edit code. Once this loads, we're going to go to assets, and then you're going to go to base CSS. Okay, so this is what it's going to look like. You're going to come all the way to the very, very bottom, and then you're going to press some enter here. And then you're going to paste that code that you've just done here. You're going to paste it here because now this is going to affect the entire website. Okay. So let's go ahead and click on save. Let's go to our front end and let's refresh. And now we've assigned that CSS to our entire website. So now our buttons will all be green. And when we hover over it, it'll be black. There we go. Oh, we have one more here. There we go. And so it will add that code to all of our primary buttons. And what are the primary buttons? Primary buttons are your main buttons. They're the first button. Okay, so that is going to add that code to those buttons. Check the description down below. I have listed several codes that you could use for a variety of different button styles. Let me know which one you're going to apply on your website. I would love to know. And until next time, my friend, adios.